I have never asked for any larger plane. I have said I'm happy to ride commercial, and if the plane they have doesn't go coast to coast, I'm happy to ride commercial and coast to coast that way.
Today, she insisted size doesn't really matter.
It's not a question of size, it's a question of distance. We want an aircraft that can reach California.
But an aircraft like that can comfortably seat 50.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi says she will block Republican attempts to lift the moratorium on offshore energy exploration because, quote, I'm trying to save the planet. I'm trying to save the planet.
You just mentioned natural gas, and you emphasized it as well in your last radio address talking about the energy plan. And then we read in the Wall Street Journal that you and your husband have made a substantial investment in the plan that T. Boone Pickens has put forward, which has a heavy emphasis on natural gas as well.
How does $335 million in STD prevention stimulate the economy?
I'll tell you how. There is I'm a big believer in prevention. And we have, there's a part of the bill on the health side of it that is about prevention. It's about it being less expensive to the states to do these prevention measures.
There's more bang for the buck, is the term they use, by investing in food stamps and in unemployment insurance than in any tax cuts.
PAYGO. PAYGO is something that we have worked very hard for in the House.
Since the opposition party under Speaker Pelosi took control of this body, the federal deficit has increased from $162 billion the first year she was Speaker in 2007 to $459 billion in 2008, and then it went up by a huge amount, $1.42 trillion in 2009. This is just an unsustainable growth rate. And over the last 3 years, we've increased the debt ceiling five times since she took office as Speaker.
PAYGO. PAYGO is something that we have worked very hard for in the House.
We've increased the debt ceiling five times since she took office as Speaker.
I have not voted from the time I've been in Congress to raise this debt ceiling, because all this really does is permit our government to borrow more money from foreign governments. We have massive unfunded promises to guarantee future entitlement benefits that, when added with liabilities like the debt, total nearly $57 trillion. That means every man, woman, and child in America owes $184,000.